This Headless Professor video is about the chi-squared test. Sometimes it's abbreviated by a Greek letter chi that looks sort of like a lazy X. I call this statistical test the Swiss Army knife of all statistical tests. This is my Swiss Army knife, or at least an imitation Swiss Army knife. And it has a variety of different tools. For example, we can open a can with it. We can open a wine bottle with it. And I've actually used this wine bottle opener in the past. And let me tell you, it's not the best wine bottle opener I've ever had. Indeed, although this is a very useful tool, and I can use it for a lot of different things, it's not the best tool for any given thing. There's a better bottle opener that I have somewhere else. Well, that's sort of like what the chi-square test is like. You can use it on a variety of different things, but it really isn't the best statistical test to use in most cases. Usually there's some other more specialized statistical test that would be better. For example, suppose you have something like this. You have two variables that you're trying to correlate here. Variable one with two different categories, variable two with two different categories, and you have this kind of 2x2 contingency table. Well, there's a version of chi-square for that, a pretty good one, called the Yates chi-square. And then there are others. Suppose you have something like this. One variable measured in two rows, another variable measured in three columns. Or suppose you have something like this. Three or more rows, three or more columns. You can also use versions of chi-square to do repeated measures, the McNemar test. Or you could even use it for ranking repeated measures, the Friedman test. But I'm going to caution you about using most versions of chi-square. There's simply too many limitations. For example, most people forget that you should have an expected cell frequency of at least 5 in each of those little boxes. Not the observed, we're talking about expected frequency. If you're less than that, some of the assumptions that chi-square has just have not been met. Let's take a look at some alternatives to chi-square. Let's go back to the 2x2 contingency table. Is there a better test to use in that kind of situation? Yes. It's called the Fisher exact probability test. Now, most people didn't use it in the past because it was very difficult to calculate. Now, computers, of course, can do that for us. Suppose we have two groups, and then we are comparing those two groups on some other scale, perhaps an ordinal scale like high, medium, and low. And we could use a chi-square there, but there is a better statistical procedure that does not have the five sample per minimum assumption. And that test is known as the Kolmogorov-Smirnov, a very robust and appropriate test to use. And suppose we have two ordinally scaled variables, high, medium, low. Instead of using the chi-square, we could use the correlation coefficient known as the Spearman-Rho, or a correlation coefficient known as Kendall's Taw. Those would be better alternatives to the chi-square. So, like the Swiss Army knife, chi-square is useful, but there are better approaches for us to learn.